When we use the Carnot map for simplifying the Boolean expression, sometimes the Boolean expression will not define the output for all the combinations of input. Such undefined combination of input, we treat it as don't care. Those minterms corresponding to which the output of the Boolean function is not defined, we treat it as don't care terms, and we mark the don't care terms as x in the Carnot map. And we can assume that this don't care term can take either 0 or 1 as the output. This we can assume depending on our convenience. If I can use this x so that I can form a bigger block in the Carnot map, then I will assume that this x value is 1 and I will form a bigger group. And otherwise, I will simply ignore the x, which means that I should cover all the ones which is defined as the output of the Boolean function in a block, or at least it should, all the ones should be covered at least in a group. But x's I need not worry about them to cover in a group. But if I use that x along with ones to form a bigger block, then I will use that x for our convenience to get the simplified expression. Consider an example. Now the Boolean function f is defined as 1 for the minterm 5, 6, 7, and the don't cares are 3 and 4. Okay, and what are these don't cares? So this combination of input might not appear in the application at all. Say for example, when we are dealing with BCD numbers, although each BCD number is represented by 4 bits, we will not consider the combination from 1010 to 1111. All these 6 combinations of inputs are invalid, and those invalid inputs will be considered as don't cares when we deal with BCD as input. Since there are 3 input variables, we use a 3 variable Carnot map, and we mark this 5, 6, 7 as 1. Okay, so this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7, minterm 7. And don't cares are 3 and 4. Okay, we mark this as x. If we don't have this don't care terms, then I can group this 2 ones together and these 2 ones together, and we should write like these 2 ones will be grouped together, and this is x followed by z. Okay, so this is x z, and then we will have okay, so these 2 ones we can form a block, and this is x z, and these 2 ones we can form another block, and we get x y. And how many gates will be necessary to implement this one? 1 AND gate here, 1 AND gate here, and then finally 1 OR gate. Totally 3 gates we will have. And since we have a don't care, we can exploit this and make this as a bigger block. I can make a single block with 4 cells together, and YZ is varying across these 4 cells, and the expression is only X. That means that I need not any computation to get the output of this function. I can redirect the input X as the output. So I can save on 3 gates. Okay, so that is the use of don't care. Kmap is a simpler tool for simplifying the Boolean expression, but the problem is that how to form the group, what are the cells that we can combine, when we have multiple terms, how big we can format, okay? We should always think for a bigger block, okay? So in that case, we need to have more practice to come up with a simplified expression. Maybe that in the next lecture, I'll deal with more examples, or I'll give you more exercise to work out and get the simplified expression. Thank you for watching this video.